next, it's a UFC bantamweight division fight. Round one is upon us between two of the best fighters in this division. Hard to find anything resembling a glaring weakness on either side when you break down.
There are no weaknesses in these guys. These guys are as well-rounded as they come. They both can wrestle, both can grapple, both can strike. They can do it all. And these are the matchups that we dream of as MMA fans.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave what it's supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming. Nice punch lands over the top.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the gentleman.
Punch coming, it's blocked.
See some of the damage cut underneath that right eye.
Massive head kick. Oh, big left hook there. Outstanding output on both sides. Oh!
Really?
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh! Massive knee to the head. Oh!
Oh, man. This grounded pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is the opponent is not controlling the bottom. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, it creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
Oh, worked hard to get up again, but he looks like he's compromised.
Man, what a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Under 2 minutes now to go in round one.
Go, guys, run!
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Close guard. Well, he gets up again here, but he looks hurt. Misses again with a right punch.
Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back in range.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Oh, and he caught the kick. A swing and a miss by Sterling. Might get the finish. We'll see if he gets it in the next round.
Well, if he lands that shot again, it will be over. It will be a finish. You don't recover from two of those types of strikes. He found the right moment. He found the opening and landed that big strike. Every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Connection with the right hand, pretty good punch that one.
Nice right punch by this young man.
That is, oh man, this dude is good.
Oh, this fight's gonna be over, DC.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high with his opponent, thought he was going low. And now he's got hurt very bad.
Nice job landing. Oh! You knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short knife for his opponent. But that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the huge knockout victory. That could hold up as one of the better knockouts of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eagle Beans.
It's a bantamweight matchup between Rafael Assuncao and Aljamain Sterling.
Ready. Ready to fight.
Round one is upon us between two of the best fighters in this division. Hard to find anything resembling a weakness on either side when you break out.
There are no weaknesses in these guys. These guys are as well-rounded as they come. They both can wrestle, both can run.
Here's Bruce Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest.
This shit is set in stone. Y'all should been getting old.
Thoughties. Coco. Pressure. Yeah. Pressure, 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 pressure. Let's go. Pressure, pressure.
Next, it's a bantamweight clash between Aljamain Sterling and Henry the Messenger Cejudo. So the fight is now underway. On one side, you have a fighter who does everything well, taking on a true grappler on the other side. It's going to be interesting to see how long he can keep it up.
I mean, Damian Maia may be the most specialist type of grappler in the UFC. This guy resembles him in a number of ways. Let's see how he manages this fight against a guy that can do just about everything inside the octagon.
Really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC. Goes for the early takedown, no problem there. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
And they both stand up.
As he gets close, he's out of the kicking range, so he'll change his stance. Big power punch, man. Now he gets back in range.
Whoa, watch the shot. Still unable to find that precise range with the high kick. Great hand there, beautifully done by Cejudo. He continues to evolve as a striker.
Big kick land.
Cejudo gets hit with that hook. He's got to be careful here. All right, so a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot. That's incoming.
Single collar timeout. Ooh, now he's got the tie pump, Daniel. If you're on the other side, what are you trying to do to get out of this potentially dangerous position?
You got to start digging your shoulder to a side and trying to shove an underhook. You cannot bend down to try to get out of Muay Thai punch.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Aljamain Sterling. So there is the horn at times in that previous round. I didn't think we'd get here after that head kick nearly had him out of there.
It was a good round leading up to that. But when you take a head kick like that, when your opponent gets your entire body into that kick, usually the night's over. Very tough to still be standing, but he can't take many more like that.
round two, Aljamain Sterling and Henry Cejudo. Just unable to quite find that range. Aljamain Sterling.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got to be doing the first round.
Oh! Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound start.
Just over 3 minutes now to go in round two. He's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground.
Oh, look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Working off his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Well, he gets up again here, but he moves. Oh! Strike to end the fight and end the night for his opponent, who candidly may not have even seen that shot coming. So just the way he drew it up, exactly what he told us during fight week, played out here on fight night. He found a little opening in his opponent's defense and barged right through it to get the big knockout win. All right, let's take a look back at the replay. It ends up in the official decision is in. Here is the veteran voice, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian Lavigne has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 38 seconds of round number two. Going to winner by knockout, Henry the Messenger Cejudo.
Right, so there he is, the man of the moment, celebrating one of the bigger knockout victories of his career. And that'd be nice sometimes with all the hard work that you guys put in when it goes down exactly the way you drew it.
A lot of people talk about doing certain things. It's harder to deliver on those promises you make to the public. Tonight, you did exactly that. Congratulations.
Thank you. just fight. Dax.
Left me out to dry, had to crucify. Stab me in my back, you ain't my dog, you getting euthanized. Lying on the gang and speaking down, that shit is suicide. Black ain't no excuse, ain't getting off because we unified. Came through faster, we move faster, yeah, we move faster. Can't stop till we beat you bastards. With me and meet your master. Won't come last, we move right past. Destroy that night, eat you rappers. You move faster, we move fast. If you go fast, we must go fast and even faster. Came through faster, we move faster, yeah, we move faster. Can't stop till we beat you bastards. With me and meet your master. Won't come last, we move right past. Destroy that night, eat you rappers. You
coming up next, it's a bantamweight clash between Aljamain Sterling and Sean O'Malley.
You ready?
these guys have been on each other's radars for quite some time. Tonight, it shall be done. Both guys well-rounded. You think the kickboxing match is not good.
You just don't know, right? You don't know who's going to be able to employ their strategy the way that... He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of fixing everything.
Whoa! Big knee to the body!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this one. Oh! Don't finish his fight.
Aljamain Sterling pouring it on!
Oh! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Wow!
Right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. All right, let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with in the truck. This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every realm of the game.
A full-on display of all of his skills. He did everything in this championship-winning performance. He used his wrestling. He used his elbows. He used his pace and pressure to really wear down his opponent so that he can get his hand raised.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Leving has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 30 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Sugar Sean.
Chance to you. Ooh. If I make another wish, I'll wish for a wish for you. for you. Hey.
One, two.
ECAD, you heard of these lads. The myth that we made a grip, never broke. Truly the Cadillac, I had to contract L's on the quick.
Stick them up, slick, talking no tricks.
It's the funniest shit. Finally, the money up a print on the kid. The plan to get shit. Living in the valley, oh!
All right, coming up next, it's a bantamweight matchup between Dominic Cruz and Aljamain Sterling. Other's radars for quite some time. Tonight, it shall be done. Both guys well-rounded. You think the kickboxing match is signed to one?
You just don't know, right? You don't know who's going to be able to employ their strategy the way that they need to. It's a close fight on paper, and also in every performance we have seen them put on, these guys seem to be the mirror image of each other.
That punch, no good. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the jump. Yeah, he picks it all up.
Oh, massive kick. Didn't see that one coming. So both guys landing it well here. Good action early. Sterling gets hit by that kick to the midsection. You gotta do better defensively.
Beautiful punch.
Nice combination of strikes there by Cruz. Oh, he lands a knee to the body now, DC. Talk to us about that strike.
They suck so bad.
Right hand! Back to the feet! Oh, wow. Massive uppercut. That would not feel good. Oh! 32 total. Oh, he is up, but man, is he hurt! A finish could come here at any time. Whoa!
He's in trouble. He's hurt.
Oh, he might be out. To go in a back and forth first round here. Oh! Throwing haymakers out of the exchange. Oh! Knee to the body. Timing his shots nicely there, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Oh, there's the head kick. Looked like there might have been a window there instead. It is blocked. Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. He'll finish the fight.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Oh, wicked nice leg kick there, DC.
Can't take too many of those.
Oh! Aljamain Sterling pulling it off!
He needs to start looking to finish now.
Shot to end the fight right there. It couldn't have landed much more flush than it did, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, quite frankly. So near perfect execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here tonight. Alright, we'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're gonna find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight, but don't ignore all the work he did with his hands and give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way. And in order to get a fight of the night like you got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Leving has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 50 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Aljamain Pumpmaster Sterling.
All right, so there he is, the man of the hour. What a massive knockout for him to get this win in style tonight.
He did everything he needed to do to find the knockout. Now he can celebrate with his family and friends as they earn this victory. So, trying to make a million while I'm living. Caught a couple brothers in the
Mm-hmm.